Camden Aerodrome is located in the western part of Sydney, out past Campbelltown and Bankstown. It's in Class D airspace when it's operational, and the rest of the time it's Class G, directly underneath Sydney's Class C airspace.
We have some unusual features about Camden, namely the altitude, which some people get confused. The altitude at Camden for the circuit is 1,300. And typically the joining instruction altitude is 1,800.
From the north, the best inbound point would be Bringelly. It can be slightly harder to identify as the inbound point's over the top of a small shopping centre on the northern road. But slightly to the west of it is a big brickworks, which has a big cream shed. So that's a great identification feature to help you to go inbound via there. Mayfield's more to the northwest of Camden, and it's easily identifiable by a few different features. The main feature there is there's a big horseshoe in the river and a set of power lines that go across there. There's also a big racetrack where they train the horses. And so again, 1,800 is a good height to go inbound via Mayfield.
If you're joining inbound from the north via Mayfield, depending on the runway direction, but you'd typically be given a leg of the circuit to join with an altitude of 1,800, and we would typically get you to report at a 2 mile position, which is at the point where we would expect to give you descent, depending on what traffic was operating in the circuit at the time. But it's very important that all pilots maintain 1,800 until cleared for a visual approach. Then that's reference any aircraft that might be operating beneath you in the circuit at 1,300.
Coming in via Bringelly, one thing to remember is you may be asked to track via Oran Park, which is no longer the raceway that it used to be. It is now a small township, a brand new development, lots of houses, a small town centre and what have you. So that's often used to track via Oran Park if they're doing straight-in approaches to runway 24.
With the Oaks, it's very important to realise that the VFR approach point is the Oaks Township, but just to the west of the Oaks Township is the Oaks ALA, which is separate from Camden, and the circuit altitude at the Oaks is 1,900. So it's very important that pilots operating in that vicinity make sure that they are well above that circuit altitude prior to calling inbound to Camden. The VTC has a marking on it that recommends that pilots descend not below 2,500 until they're clear of the area. Inbound from the south, depending on whether or not gliders are operating at Camden. If they're not operating, typically from an angle in Picton, you'll be told to track direct to Camden at 1,800 with a report of 3 miles or 2 miles, depending on what's happening on the day. If gliders are operating, we tend to segregate the VFR aircraft inbound from the gliders, and we'll use two prominent landmarks, one being Narellan Town Centre and the other one being the township of Mount Hunter.
Mount Hunter's about midway between the Oaks and the airfield, and it's pretty much off the end of runway 24, slightly off to the left.
So operating to the south of Camden, remember that there is a drop zone, Wilton, which is a busy drop zone, and it's important to be clear of that drop zone when it is active. Coming off Victor 1 southbound, be aware of the Holsworthy restricted area. Don't turn too early. So make sure that you're tracking towards the Stanmore Park before turning towards the west, and that'll keep you well clear of Holsworthy restricted area.
One thing that Camden does a lot of is gliding. About 4 days a week, it's pretty active with gliders, and you can have four or five gliders airborne at any time. So you come from Menangle, you need to be very mindful of the fact that there are gliders out there, and air traffic control will try to point all of them out to you if you're coming in from there, but you need to actually be very, very aware, situationally aware of where the traffic is and where you need to go.
If the glider ops are active, they're probably going to send you up via Narellan to get in to the circuit area. So just be aware of that too. You're going to be tracking further away. When you're inbound from from one of those inbound points we've just spoken about, it's critical that you don't go below 1,800 feet until the tower has told us to. And the way in which they're going to identify that is by clear visual approach. So do not descend below 1,800 feet until you've been cleared visual approach. That's probably one of the biggest errors that pilots make coming into Camden. And you've got to remember there are people departing and doing circuits at 1,300 feet.
Helicopter pilots use the same approach points as fixed wing, as indicated on the VDC chart. As a general rule, we approach to the main helipad, which is located directly northwest of the 0624 runway.
The northern area is the main flying training area for both Camden and Bankstown. and there's, you know, there's multiple flying schools here and many flying schools out at Bankstown as well. So especially on days like today, where it's a really nice day, there is going to be lots of traffic. And it's important to be vigilant, keep your eyes out, and make sure you're not maintaining one position at any one time. So try and change your position up so that you're easy to see to other airplanes as well. So the best frequency to use out there is mainly dependent on your flying school. Highly recommended is 124.55, as you'll actually hear both IFR and VFR traffic within your vicinity. And then if for some reason Sydney does need to contact you, they will be able to get in contact with you. They will only paint you as a VFR traffic, so you need to be aware of that. Camden has a ground frequency, 121.9, so it's important to be on that frequency while getting those clearances.
There's a habit of people reporting approaching the reporting point, and you have to ask the question, what is approaching the reporting point? So it's designed to report directly over the top of the reporting point. And the other biggest mistake probably is people that descend below 1,800 feet, if that's been the level they've been given, before they are instructed to actually make a visual approach or to descend a circuit height, for instance.
Yankee Zulu Delta Camden Tower, join base runway 24 direction, maintain 1,800, report again at 2 miles.
So it's important that you, if you've been instructed to be at 1,800, you stay at 1,800 until you receive those the instructions to do otherwise.